Hello, ladies and gentlemen, and welcome to Let's Play Don't Starve, or otherwise unofficially known as A Touch of Class. Now, this is a series, or a couple series, actually, which I'm interested in doing, where I learn how to better play games, which I'm interested in being better at, but I'm not particularly good at the moment. So, Don't Starve is one of those games, and I thought I'd start it off with it. So, without further ado, we're gonna get in and we're gonna make our world. Hit play here. You can see that I do have some experience with this game. I would not claim to be proficient in it at all, but I have survived a decent amount. So, we are going to start a new world. We're going to play Reign of Giants to start off with, and I think, as far as characters go, I've given a lot of thought to who I want to play, but I think this time around we want to start with Wilson, the gentleman scientist. What's more appropriate, right? So, yeah, let's get into this. And, I don't think we're gonna make it compatible with Shipwrecked at this point in time. But yeah, as I was saying, I'm very interested in playing games that I'm interested in being better at, but am not at the moment. So I want these to be learning series where I play them in order to learn more about the game and hopefully progressively get better over time and be able to see that throughout the duration of the series. I have not changed any settings on this world, as you saw, so we're going to be playing this as more or less Don't Starve is intended to be played. Alrighty. So let's make an effort to get some supplies. First things first, we want food, at least to tide us over until the next day. We want basic supplies. We want to be able to craft a tool to chop down wood. And the question is, well, there's two questions. Where are we going to set up base, and how long do we want to take until we make our base? Which I guess is kind of the secondary question to that. I am a fan of setting up base quickly and using the time that we don't spend traveling around to be able to gather our resources and kind of get a head start. As for locations, I really like to, I favor areas that are kind of restricted in their access points. Wow, we got a lot of food around here. This is real good. This is real good. I don't know if we're going to want to stick around here, but it's a good place to start, certainly. Alright, so we're going to want to get some wood, but we're going to get wood later in the day, I think, as it gets closer to evening time. In Reign of Giants, we start in spring, and so we will be moving through the spring into summer, where it gets quite warm. But for the time being, we just have to deal with rain. Except, it seems that we... I made this Reign of Giants? Yeah, it's clearly Reign of Giants. I'm wondering why there's rabbits out. It seems as though it's summer, so maybe we're actually starting in summer, which changes things significantly. It means we're going to want to set up close proximity to this prairie. We're going to make best use of these rabbits. It seems like we... No, more prairie, which I'm not complaining about, certainly. It's a good place to be near. Yeah, but we're going to want to make best use we can of these rabbits, and there are quite a lot of them. If we could find some beefalo, that would be great for farming. Seems like we have a little corpse over here. As well as some noises. Oh, hello. Mr. Amphibian Men? Hello? Oh, shit. Pigmen and Amphibian Men are fighting. No, I wanted that. What is this? Hey, give me that fish. I got frog legs. Got some meat. Well, this is quite nice. Not that I support your needless violence, but... Are you... Alright, I'll take that. We seem to have been given a boon. Grab that, grab that. Who's gonna win? That's the question. I think it's gonna be the fishmen. Oh. It could go either way. It could go either way. It depends on who throws the next punch. Wait, can you finish this so I can get my food and move on, please? They're scared. Come on, I'll be the ref. There we go. Winner is Fishman. Much respect, Merm. So I guess he wins. He gets the hut. He has claimed this land as his own, as they did in the Old West. We got a grass suit, which is not bad. It's not great, but it's better than nothing, certainly, until we get a log suit. It's getting closer to evening time, so we're going to want to harvest some... we're going to want to harvest some wood, I'm thinking. Man, more berries. This is not a bad seed, truthfully. I still want to find a defensible position. Somewhere near the ocean, somewhere with a choke point. That'll make it fairly easy to set up an infrastructure. And basically what I'm saying, the less walls we have to build, the better. And so if I can find a location that facilitates that, that'll be really nice. We can also pick up flowers, which will be good when it starts to rain, although I don't know if it's going to rain all that much in the summer. I truly don't know why we're starting in the summer, honestly. Because the games I've played recently, which inspired me to do these series, I started in the spring, so it's very curious. Oh, look. Another convenient... Okay, I'm going to stay true to my word and make an effort to harvest some wood before the evening hours. Hopefully we have time still. I don't think that flowers are going to spawn all that much in summer, so we're going to try to avoid picking those at the moment. Let's build this and start getting some trees. We're going to want to build our fire far enough away as to not burn down the entire forest. That's probably an ideal. Hey, look, another berry bush. We're doing fine on food right now. More than fine, honestly. This will keep us going for quite a while, I should figure. We have plenty of meat. The fish is going to go bad earliest, so we should probably cook that and eat it. The rest of it is going to last longer than that. And, yeah, there might be an area down here that could be valuable. I kind of like this area because there's a lot of bushes. There's just a lot of everything in this small little forest area. It doesn't give us a good geographical advantage, unfortunately. In fact, quite the opposite. It's rather open. But there's a lot of raw materials around here. We have green mushroom here, which will be good for sanity. We can drop that right now. And I'm inclined to think that we should just set up here, kind of down along this coastline. Whether or not that's the best long-term solution, I'm not quite sure. I think we'll give it another day of local exploration. But it's not going to be that bad, I don't think. So we'll set up a campfire here. Take the time to harvest the nearby materials, because we have space for them. And we'll keep our fire lit and last through the incredibly short night, because it is summer. Alrighty, my sanity is fine for the moment. We're going to want to cook a fish, maybe two, depending on how much food it provides us. I'll actually cook all the fish, because it was not quite as good as I would have hoped. But certainly better than nothing. And then we can hold on to this in case we need it for sanity regeneration at some point. The red cap is useless to us unless we feed it to a villager of some sort. And we're not going to want to eat that until we need sanity. There's some berries too. Keep us stopped off. Ready for a day of adventuring. Perfect. Alright, so we'll just wait through the night. And I think we want to explore this area. Seems like a good idea. Yeah, I don't think we're going to see much of anything over here. It's really good to have bees nearby too. As kind of a long-term resource, bees are going to be useful in sanity and healing, I believe. I'm not quite sure. One thing we do want to keep an eye out for is we're going to need... I noticed that darkness is encroaching quickly. We're going to need gold. And quite a bit of it, honestly, depending on what our tech tree ends up looking like. So I'm going to want to go and harvest that if we can find it. We do have rocks around here, but no gold rocks. We haven't necessarily found like a quarry biome. So let's make an effort to go up here and explore a little bit more and see if there's an area we want to set up other than this. You know, on second thought though, given that we have such a mobile food source, such a sustainable inventory, I'm wondering if it might be more valuable to go and explore. See, there's not a whole lot up here. It seems like this is a fairly restricted location, which means we're going to have to go either far to the left or far to the right to get out of the area that we're not familiar with. And I'm not sure if that's a good thing. We could go back over there kind of where we started and see if there's more to be seen in that forest. There's a swamp here, which will probably... Oh, it's actually much closer than I thought it was. I thought we were going to have to go well around. This is a good resource for us. Swamp biomes are not necessarily the most uncommon, but they're not the most common. There's a spider nest there. Yeah, this is very interesting. I want to see if I can get through to the other side, just to have a peek at what might be over there. And see if it's a better option for us, or at least for future reference. Oh, there we go. I was about to say it's going on much longer than I expected it to. We have another boon here, which is great. I think that's what they're called. Oh, I don't necessarily want that to degrade in quality. Ow! Ow, shit! Alright. We'll come back to this. That's a merm hut. And there's more... Oh, hello. I guess that's just merm merchandise. Merm signals. Okay, this is a huge... huge swamp with a handful of valuable resources, but otherwise it's just kind of a death field, so I think we definitely don't want to go this direction. Looking at our map for a moment, we definitely don't want to go this direction. This direction is okay, but not a whole lot of resources out there, and then this direction is fairly similar to our area here, so I'll tell you what. I don't think we have enough time in the day to go and explore over here necessarily, but if we want to take tomorrow to go and do so, and actually since we haven't established a base camp, we might as well go there with our remaining time for the day. So let's go over there and figure out if there's anything. Oh, hello. What is that? It's a log suit and a bunch of boards. That's fantastic, actually. Alright, we're going to need to remember where these things are. That's a huge, huge amount of resources for us. And it's going to be extremely useful in accelerating our tech tree. Reeds are also very good. I really want to pick them right now, but I don't have the inventory space. So I'm not necessarily going to worry about it. We have a lot of aggregate resources in this area. The only thing we're really missing is gold and ready access to that. Hell, we could just take the wormhole and see where that takes us. But I'm not necessarily sure that that provides us with a whole lot of benefit at the moment. Yeah, we're going to continue going this direction. I can cut down here and see if there's anything over here. This seems just like typical forest. Nothing too unusual. Yeah. But yeah, as you can see, I have a fairly decent knowledge of how the game works. As far as Reign of Giants go, I'm less informed, especially as you get to long-term survival. I've learned a lot in the past couple days while streaming this game, and I think it's gone a long way to helping me survive, but I still have a lot to learn, which is why I wanted to do these series. I've been looking and searching and really, really racking my brain for series that I would enjoy doing, that people would enjoy watching, moreover, that are not outplayed or kind of have their portion of the market cornered. Well, this is interesting. Unfortunately, there's no valuable resources there for us, but... Okay, okay. I might have gotten my hopes up. Yeah, it doesn't seem like we have any rocks here. Dang. But yeah, I was looking to do series. Oh goodness, I'm getting messages. How unprofessional. Ooh, and some gold. This is really good. This is really good. Well, I spoke too soon, apparently. Although... perhaps... well, that's a ring. It's getting to be nighttime. Oh, this is an excellent location, I think. It is somewhat far removed from all of our resources here, as well as these areas, which are going to be our main food source. But I think that as far as geographic locations go, you can't beat this. This is really good for us, I think. But yeah, I wanted series that were Let's Plays, but were also something more, were games that I was going to enjoy playing, people were going to enjoy watching, and were things that were fairly persistent, and yet not completely monopolized or completely saturated for kind of the behind-the-scenes logic to the entire thing. But the point is, I'm going to enjoy playing Don't Starve, and I'm looking forward to it, certainly. Alright, so we're going to need more raw resources that we're lacking significantly. I think our best goal will be to plan on this being our permanent base of operations, but for the period of like 2 or 3 days, spending our time in this region and kind of gathering as many raw resources and transporting them back here, transplanting them, if you will. Although we'll need a shovel, so I guess our priority is a science machine, which we need 1 gold for. Okay, this is attainable. This is attainable. This is something that we can do. In the meantime, it seems as though we're just going to wait out the night. And I'm going to take the opportunity to kind of chop down some trees in the local area, because I'm not interested in having a whole lot of trees around here. I like this, though. This is the kind of area that I think is very, very valuable and very good for being able to defend yourself and isolate yourself from potential threats. We're going to have to get rid of these flowers at some point. They're going to do a number on our sanity whenever we pass them, which is not particularly good, but that's okay. I'm not too worried about that. As for my long-term goals for the series, well, I'd like to be able to, there's a lot of things to do in Don't Starve that I haven't even scratched the surface of. There's a lot of complex kind of survival mechanics to tap into. There's obviously just surviving long enough to see a majority of the game's content. There's a story mode. There's Shipwrecked now, which adds an entire layer of depth to it. I don't know if there's any reason in going back from Reign of Giants to the base game. I think that just tracks things. I don't think Reign of Giants separates any content from the base game. So, but yes, there's plenty of longevity to this, and as far as I'm aware, they're still actively updating the game with new content. So it should have quite a bit of lifespan to it, I would think. As far as other series that I'm currently thinking about and planning on doing for A Touch of Class, I'm currently thinking about doing a Gungeon series, because Gungeon is a game that interests me. I'm still not sure how I feel about Enter the Gungeon, but to me it feels as though it's a game that would be extremely satisfying to be good at and to have proficiency in, but I find it extremely frustrating because I don't possess that level of proficiency. So I think that's something I would like to go for. Can I not eat? Thank you. We're still working on getting our health back from when we were attacked. But all in good time. All in good time. Yeah, we're going to need to do something about these flowers. Their aura is going to be dangerous, to say the least. But oh, we already had a pickaxe. Well, that's just lovely. Drop that there for the time being. We can gather another red cap, which will be useful if we need, oh, come on. Come now. Pick that up and combine those. And then take those back here. Yeah, I'm wondering if it's more valuable to just deal with the flowers now and take the sanity loss, then take the incremental sanity loss every time we pass them. Oh, you know what? We might be able to light them on fire. That might be our best solution to this situation. Excuse me. Oh, hello. A, koalaphant is in the area, it seems. We're definitely not well enough prepared to fight it, unfortunately. It would be a good source of food. But we are not equipped for that quite yet. Is there another rock around here that I can take the time to mine? I'd prefer to use up the rest of this pickaxe so I have the inventory space. There's one down here. Just a normal rock. I'm wondering why gold rocks don't show up on the minimap. It seems strange that that's the case. I thought I had that other pickaxe in my inventory, but it seems I have neglected in doing my diligence. Oh well. We have plenty of gold. I don't necessarily want to take this back right now, but I do want to put it in the path of where I'm going to be going back. Only one? I thought I got two. Perhaps not. Alright, we'll drop that on the road. And see if there's anything else valuable around here. Is this all a dead end? It doesn't seem like it. There are so many boons here. I cannot believe. Oh, look at this cute little... Oh, it's a brush hat. Seriously, the number of boons that we're experiencing. Also, we've discovered a quarry area, which is extremely generous. This is a good seed. I'm enjoying this seed. I think it's very good for us, and it's going to be very valuable in the long run. What we are going to do... Man, there were boards somewhere, weren't there? I believe there were boards there. Yeah, there were boards there. Alright. So we need to figure out how exactly we're going to manage our resources. Why am I picking up seeds at the moment? I don't know. I couldn't necessarily tell you. One thing I want to try... Before I forget, and before I continue to talk about this, as if it's an issue. Yes, light that on fire. There we go. Wonderful. We got a bunch of ash, which I can't carry anyway, and it's all going to blow away in this beautiful spectacle. Let's watch it. Why is this log on the ground? Carry anything. Goodness gracious. Drop that up there. There you go. It's all blown away. Like dust in the wind. Alrighty. We have some resources up here. I don't want to abandon the log, certainly. Don't plant that. Drop it. Rocks, you can drop that. Or not. Axe, we're going to want to hold on to. Seeds, we have no reason to get rid of, truthfully. That's all food. And those are raw resources. I completely forgot we have 14 carats. And I ain't talking about the gold. It is 24 carats. Mineral junks, aren't they hilarious? Yes, so... Ooh, it's nighttime. So we'll probably stick it out here for another night, and then tomorrow make a legitimate effort to travel to where we need to be. In the meantime, is there anything else around here? No, it doesn't seem that we do, but this is really good. We have a good collection of biomes here. The only thing I see that we're lacking is access to perhaps spiders. There was one spider generation over in here, which would be nicer if it was larger and more prolific, perhaps. But that also presents a decent amount of threat, so I don't know if we want that. In the meantime, we're going to chill here. I feel bad just standing around, but at this point in the game, there's not a whole lot we can do. We're going to want to eat our meat, because that's going to be important for us. We're slowly losing sanity, but we have quite a bit of it because we're Wilson. At least I think that's how that works. We have a torch, so I'm not too scared to go out and venture. I thought there was something else worth picking up over here. I'm wondering if the land continues in this direction. I don't think it does. I think it runs into a terminal edge. Which is, by the way, a great name for a band. Oh, this is also a good location. In fact, it may be a better space for gating ourselves off than that corner up there. It provides a lot of property in front of it, which is forest biome. In that sense, it doesn't really differ from this area, but it might be better to position ourselves there. Yeah, I think I like that better, because it gives us, if you consider that we'll eventually endeavor to wall off sort of a cross-section here, it provides much more area, surface area, as compared to the amount of resources required to build a wall, so that's very good. I'm slightly concerned about this swamp area. I don't think it actually presents any challenges to us. I don't think independent swamp like this really can grow or spawn any enemies of note. Oh shit. Well, I think we may have to survive on a torch, a single torch. What do I need? I need more grass. Oh goodness gracious. There's grass up here. Run. Okay. We can make another torch to make it so we don't die in the night. Oh god, I can't believe this is what it's come to. There are two grass nodes around here. Alright. I'm trying my best to survive. Oh, we can also make a bonfire. At this point, I don't even know if it's worth it. We might as well just travel into the darkness through the night. We want to make sure we're not going too far off of where we should be, and I don't necessarily want to venture into any unvetted territory on just the light of a torch. In an emergency, we can light the forest on fire, but I prefer not to do that. Okay. It seems like we are going to survive, albeit at a somewhat significant sanity loss. We're making our way back into this area. Oh, we also didn't cook to eat, which is going to be an obstacle soon. What do we need? I suppose our goal should have been to make a science machine now, shouldn't it? Well, in the meantime, we'll do our best to harvest some materials, and we'll make it back to our location. I'm confident in positioning us there as our permanent residence. I think that's a good place to be, and I think it's going to serve us well, you know, barring my inadequacies and my oversights in resource gathering, which is what I'm going to prioritize today. If we can get decent-sized stacks of both grass and sticks, we're going to be in good shape to be able to continue to make fires. Luckily, we still have plenty of food to do as well in the short term. And even though I should be cooking these, they're doing fine at the moment. Look at all these rabbits. We have our Merm. Hello, Merm. I'm going to call you Marv. Marv the Merm, who will survive until we decide that his life is no longer of value to us. At which point we will murder him for his frog legs and fish. But it's far too early to be speaking of war. We are a nation-state, a city-state even, that is not yet prepared for the endeavors of political conflict. What am I talking about? Who knows? Yeah, we have plenty of food. Some of it's kind of going to waste, which I feel bad. Hopefully we're going to eat everything before it's spoiled. But, Yes. It would have been nice if I was able to bring the resources with me. And you know what? Here's what we're gonna do. Let's run up here. We've gathered a decent amount of resources. We're gonna need more wood. All in good time. All in good time. Let's walk up here. And let's gather those boards, which are up here in this ring of trees, if I remember correctly. Yes, okay. We'll gather the boards, which will allow us to build a box. And possibly some extra materials, if we play our cards right. Nothing else of value around here. I don't have a stack of anything to eat. I guess I'll just carry this with me for the moment. And we'll retire somewhat earlier just because I want to make sure that we can get a start. I was going to say a head start, but at this point it's not a head start. We can get a start on our resources. Our tech tree, that is. Which is in and of itself a sort of resource, but it is not a tangible resource that we use for survival necessarily. I'm assuming you could theoretically survive without ever developing your tech tree at all, which I was thinking, depending on how long a series like this runs and whether or not I feel as though it's more enticing to move on to a series, another series, or continue to try and achieve mastery in this series. And this is looking far, far down the line. I mean, clearly I'm not a master of this game yet, but when I am, should that day ever come, challenge? I think challenge survivals could be a lot of fun. Attempting to go, X number of days under certain conditions, arbitrary conditions imposed by us. Oh, I don't even know what you would begin to do. I know there's a bunch of settings that you can do, like permanent winter, things like that. I do also think that some of those challenges are involved in. Oh, we don't necessarily want to go up this side, although it seems like there's good resources over here. So we'll keep that in mind. I believe the story mode involves like surviving 30 days in winter or something along those lines. That's about all I know about it. But stuff like that could be valuable to us and could be a fun endeavor in the future. I'll lampshade the fact that I just said valuable to us as a filler statement while my brain actually caught up to my mouth. All right, let's drop that there. Let's make. Oh, we need to go and get our resources from up there, don't we? Well, we still have time to transpose, so let's keep that on us. Let's drop that. And this. And these for the moment. I think that's all we need. Oh, we can drop the rocks too. Right, hopefully that all afford us enough space to transport the gold, and I'm trying to remember what else. There was a pickaxe, I believe. There is the ring, which, if I understand correctly, is part of a device that resets the world, so that is not at all relevant to us at the moment. Mushrooms, which provide us no tangible benefit at the moment. And gold. Okay. So with this, we'll make a science machine, which will allow us to make a shovel, which will be very important in transposing, transplanting, transpotting, train spotting materials from that other area, the bountiful area, to our now home base. We can take this as an opportunity to build our fire pit, which signifies the claiming of this land as our place of residence. And we can make an effort to build some materials. Gold, please. Thank you. Also, cook this. Eat it. Enjoy it. There you go. Science machine. Now, where do we want to put these? This seems like a good area. This block is perfectly designed for science machines and such. What else do we want to make? We want to use the science machine to refine perhaps a board. Do we not have enough? Oh, we had to make the bonfire, of course. Let's use our axe then. And take the time to gather some more wood. This is going to be important for us, and we should probably spend a good portion of the next day doing this. We can make one more board. And with this, we can make two, count them, two, cut down this tree, two, boxes for storage, which is excellent. I didn't necessarily want to pick up. No, don't plant that. Although, we will want to plant some trees. So on second thought, plant one there. Excuse me. Plant one there. And maybe just all along this edge if we can manage it. It's alternating between planting and adding fuel. There we go. Okay. So we're going to have a kind of a line of trees here. And maybe... because we're not going to do any harvesting in our area, I think this is perfectly safe. Let's also swap with this and cook some frog legs before they start to spoil. We'll be able to eat these. Guess we'll just eat all of them because they're not that nourishing. Alright, and when the rains start to come, these trees will provide valuable shelter. That won't be until, as far as I can tell, it won't come in heavy amounts until... nope, stop. Can you drop it? Drop it. There you go. Won't come in heavy amounts until next spring, which gives us a lot of time to prepare. But in the meantime, what do we need to do? We need to make a shovel. Oh, we also need to make a box. And I don't know where we want to put these. Let's put them up here. I like using the edges as kind of arbitrary... you know, defining lines for things. Build another chest right there. Perfect. I'm very much an advocate for aesthetic. And so, under all, pretty much any circumstance, I'm going to try and make things as visually appealing and symmetrical as possible. Whether I'll succeed or not is an entirely different story. Alright, what do we want to store in here? Everything we don't need with us right now. So gold can go in there. Rocks can go in there. Seeds can even go in there. Wood will keep. The axe will keep. The rest of it is fine. Alright. And we'll put all these in here too. Having two chests is really convenient. Gives us a lot of storage space and it keeps our area clean. Look at this. This is beautiful. Alright. We will eventually clear out the trees here because we're going to hopefully... and you'll notice this about me. Every single game, every single map, despite the almost certain impending death that I'm going to experience, I always plan, I always endeavor for the long run. Because it's much better to plan for the long run and die to unforeseen circumstances, assuming that those circumstances are not due to your lack of, I don't know, what would be the short-term version of foresight? Not quite sure, but you understand what I'm saying. Lack of perspective, perhaps. Or groundedness. As long as your death is not due to a lack of that, and is rather due to unforeseen circumstances otherwise, I think it's always a good idea to plan for the future. And that extends to life, too. I'm very much a big advocate for planning... well ahead, although I learned a number of years ago that planning too far ahead can be detrimental and not conducive of a good lifestyle. I try and strike a balance in my life nowadays between planning and understanding, and I think the difference and the balance there really comes down to the philosophy, at least in my life, the philosophy of taking things one day or one step at a time, whatever it may be. Because it's very important to plan, and it's very important to have a perspective on what challenges and what obligations you have facing you. But it's also important to recognize that sometimes there's not anything you can do about that, and that's okay. Sometimes you need to take things one day at a time. And furthermore, sometimes you just need a break. And this extends to everyone, and it's one of the many tenets that American work ethic seems to have lost is that it's important to take a break, even if that break is just for you. Even if you're not doing something just because you don't want to and you'd rather do something for yourself. That's much more, that's as important, if not much more important, than any other obligation you could have to serve. And so and I think part of this is because there's no good line as to where to enact this, because it largely depends on personal responsibility. What I mean by that is, we go from a point where we're telling children that they must go to school, because we know that they would never go to school if they didn't have to. Oh look, there's two mermen now. That they must go to school. And there's no good point to tell people, well, I mean, if you're not feeling it today, then you can take a mental health day, is what my family always called them. Which was essentially a parent-endorsed skip school day. And it was always nice. I thought it was always helpful because it was always an opportunity for us to catch up on our homework, perhaps counterintuitively. It was a day which was more constructive than a sick day. And more productive. And if we had an option, if we had agency in making the decision that we wanted to stay home, we also took partial responsibility for being productive. And so I think in a lot of ways that was actually a very good thing, and it's a very good way for teaching children to learn responsibility and personal agency. So what I'm doing here is I'm just gathering saplings and grass tufts, and I'll probably camp out here for the evening. Don't dig that up. Because I want to gather more or less as many of these resources as we could want. I don't know if there's an area down here that would be better for us to camp, that would allow us to gather resources this night, this evening. If my voice is a little crackly, I guess, I apologize. Not only have I been streaming and screaming today, but I'm also trying to be quiet as to not disturb my roommates. Hopefully it doesn't sound too bad. If it does, I'll be sure to remedy that in the future. Alright, so let's make an effort here to not... Ooh, okay, we're out of sapling space. So let's drop that for a moment. I knew that was going to break and I wasn't too concerned with it. And I think we're good. Okay, yeah. We'll gather one more stack of each, which will be more than enough. I think that's 30 of each. Yeah, that's a huge, huge amount for us. Plenty. In terms of long-term... Ooh, bushes, though. I think I'd like two stacks of berry bushes. I think that would be good. And I think we can do that within the next day. So, yeah. 30 saplings and grass tufts, and then 20 berry bushes will be a good kind of miniature farm, I guess. And I don't have to feel bad about using this as fuel, because we're going to get more of it, and we're going to actually have some that we can't take with us. So it's good to use that. Make use of it somehow. And the day resumes. Awesome. Alright, so we're going to want to, yeah, prioritize these berry bushes. We need 13 more of those. We need some more saplings, of which there are plenty. And now we're going to want to keep an eye out for manure. One thing we can do is we can let petals degrade into rot, and we can use that rot to fertilize our grass and our berry bushes. But until we find a source to fertilize them, our ability to get actual profit out of them, actual benefit, is essentially zero. Because grass tufts and berry bushes need to be fertilized. I suppose I should be trying to explain things for people that might be unfamiliar with the game. It seems as though I feel that most people are more familiar with it than I am, but I suppose that's not entirely the case. And so I should make an effort to explain what I'm doing. In case it wasn't evident, I'm gathering saplings and grass tufts, which allow me to grow these things in other locations, which is very useful. Alright, so we have a little bit of shovel left. We want some more berry bushes. We're maxed on twigs, so I'm probably going to drop these so we can make space for berry bushes. We also have a decent amount of berries, which is very good for us, for a short-term food supply. Not sustainable, not yet anyway, but short-term, very valuable. I'm going to have to make another shovel, and I'm hoping... Yeah, we have plenty of tool resources at the moment. So that was all the berry bushes here. Let's go up here and gather some more. If we don't get quite to 10, two stacks of 10, then that's okay. It's not the end of the world, certainly. And like I said, we can't fertilize them yet anyway, so we're not missing out on anything. But for the sake of even numbers and symmetry, I like to maximize our potential gains. I'm wondering, and it's probably valuable, given the lack of trees out here, I'm thinking that might be beefalo territory. And if it is, we're very lucky, because beefalo produce manure, and manure allows us to fertilize our crops and, perhaps more importantly, make farms. And farms are an excellent utility in the crafting of... Excuse me. I'm trying to figure out where there are more bushes. But I'm not seeing any. Around there, perhaps? I don't know. Maybe we'll come across them. I don't know why the music stopped. That was very odd. It seems like there are exactly two bushes within kind of the path back to our base. Oh, excuse you. I would fight you if I had a spear. But I'm not quite sure why he's violent towards me. They weren't violent earlier, were they? I don't think so. Yeah, we're going to want manure. And we're going to want rocks, which we are in no short supply of, given this area over here. There's also some region down below, which might be valuable in exploring. I'm not so sure, though. It seems mostly like forest. Evil flowers. Ooh, it's an evil forest. Totally normal tree, of course. I have no idea what function those trees provide. What benefit they give us. Where was that bush? It's right here. I want this bush. This is a nice bush, and I'm taking it for myself. Alright, that is an excellent inventory. Oh, well, excuse me. There was one right there. You get to live. You know what? I'm feeling generous today. Alright, so let's take this as an opportunity to go back to our base and set up. I love these trees. They're very, they're very, if Dr. Seuss animated a Tim Burton film, that's what those trees would be. I want to hesitate to comparing this game. Also, we have a wormhole here, which will be useful to explore. Maybe we'll do that tomorrow. I want to hesitate to compare this game to a Tim Burton film too much, because I feel as though people who are familiar with it might find that to be an overused comparison. And I endeavor to find more nuanced and refined explanations than that. But for the meantime, it will suffice. We don't have all that much wood, so tomorrow we probably need to prioritize getting wood above anything else. We should cook berries, because we have a wealth of them. That'll top us off. Tapenade. Okay. Yeah, I guess we'll log this area tomorrow. And in the meantime, I want this area to be largely for functional items. So I don't want there to be any farming here. I don't know, can we plant these in this area? I guess we can. There's no detriment to doing so, but it's still slightly close. So tomorrow we'll cultivate this region. Like I said, we're probably going to get rid of everything here. Which is okay. We're going to have plenty of sticks. I'm really happy with our supplies. This is a really good thing to have at the beginning, especially considering that we need to be able to produce a bunch of traps for this area. That's going to be our sustainable source of food through the winter. And if it's summer right now, then we're definitely going to want to be able to harvest those in abundance in the future. That's a dense forest down there, which, if my experience is in keeping with the actual game mechanics, that should have a decent amount of spiders in it, as you would expect. You know, deep forest, deep dark forest spiders, they tend to go together, which will be good for the future. How's our sanity? Our sanity is fine, and honestly, in all capacities, we're doing just fine right now. I really am still having difficulties piecing together why exactly summer is not only our first season, but why it is not dangerous to us in any capacity. I suppose it's perhaps, oh, you know what we need to do? Thinking about it, before we forget, we need to prototype a spear. Wonderful. Yeah, this is useful for us. And here we have our trees protecting us from the rain. I'm wondering why we're not dying from heat, why we don't need to produce an endothermic fire or anything like that. I'm wondering if there might be a grace period from starting the game that essentially makes it so you're not at risk of dying. At least you're not subject to certain game mechanics, because of how difficult they would be to manage, given the fact that you just started the game. I don't know, I'm curious. I do appreciate, though, it not being spring, so we're not constantly getting soaked by the rain, because that is incredibly, incredibly frustrating. To the point of me actively complaining about it as it's raining on me, but anyone who's ever yelled at the sky can tell you that that doesn't necessarily help with the situation at all. Excuse me. Can you please add more fuel to that? Thank you. That was very scary. Okay, so we're going to take one day to cultivate this area, I guess, for which we're going to need an axe, which we will swap with this. We can leave the shovel. Actually, we'll want that shovel too. So let's just drop. I don't want to plant anything. I just want to drop this. Thank you. Drop that. Cool. Alrighty. Oh, we need a pickaxe too. Wonderful. Should we burn down some of these trees? I'm thinking yes. I'm thinking any trees that are not... And we can leave supplies on the ground right now. Eat these seeds. That's fine. Any trees that are not actively providing us with wood when we cut them down, like this disheveled one right here, I think. Oh, okay, hold on. We should abstain for the moment, because I realize lighting that is going to probably catch our supplies on fire, so we don't want to do that. Let's drop these off over here with the rest of ours, and now we can do this. No, don't chop that. I need that for better purposes. And now light this on fire. So what this will do is this will create charcoal for us, which will be useful because charcoal allows us to build a number of rather good items as far as efficiency goes. It allows us to build drying racks. I think so. I think charcoal's used in drying racks. And more importantly, it allows us to build a crock pot. I guess I can drop this on the ground right now. And crock pots are incredible when it comes to food efficiency. They're largely considered to be a high priority when it comes to starting a new world. As it stands, our food economy is quite good, and we haven't necessarily had to struggle for that, so it hasn't been as high of a priority as it might otherwise be for us. But and we'll clear this rock, which is a gold rock, at least. Oh, there's two rocks, in fact. I'm trying my best to space out the areas that that we're chopping down trees to avoid getting tree guardians, because they are incredibly difficult to deal with at this point in the game. The rain is soaking us, which is unpleasant to say the least, but I think it's going to be manageable. It doesn't seem to be raining all that much in summertime, so we don't have to be too worried. See, it stopped, so we'll dry out. And we will just cut down the rest of these trees, dig up their stumps, and we'll have a good amount of supplies. No, we're actually full on stacked, so let's go and drop some more. We also have a chest. I suppose we could be using that, but why bother? Alright, that gives us plenty of room to collect the rest of the supplies. Hopefully we'll be able to finish this before evening. I'm not quite sure if we'll get everything done. But I think we have time. Oh, goodness. I was hoping that axe might last. Oh, well. It's going to cost me another whole flint and one twig, to make another axe. And considering that's all it takes, they're very resilient axes. Don't make another shovel. You already have one. And there's one more tree, two rocks, and then one twig. One single twig. It's okay. Axes are never not useful. You're going to continue to need them. Eventually, you're going to hopefully make them out of gold, which have higher resilience than normal flint, but it's very interesting to me that gold is a renewable resource in this game. When you think renewable resource, you don't necessarily think gold as something that you persistently have, but if you play your cards right, that is exactly what it is. Alright, so we have a number of pine cones, which I think we'll hold on to for the time being. Let's make an effort to light a fire here. Three should do it. I want to take the rest of these and put them in boxes until we decide it's prudent to plant them, which will be in the near future. Put the rest of them. Hopefully we have enough chest space. I think we have just enough. What happened to all our rocks? I could have sworn we had more than that. Looks like we don't have room for the charcoal right now, but we'll just drop that over here. And we are fairly well equipped. Let's cook some carrots and make sure that we are in fact not starving. Did we put petals in here? No, we do not have petals around, so let's drop these petals. Oh, we made a garland. That's what happened to them. That makes sense. Probably should have made an effort to do this earlier rather than later. As night presses towards us, it becomes increasingly dangerous. We have niter. Not necessarily an excessive amount, But some. And rocks and flint and gold. Alright. Good, good, good. And we have a quarry near us. At least what I'm choosing to call a quarry. I don't know if that's actually what the biome is referred to, but... we actually do have space for the charcoal by combining stacks like an intelligent person. Yeah. Alright, so... looking good. Looking good. We are well underway. We're going to make an endeavor to farm, effectively. We want to get our materials up and running as we kind of set up our home base here. We're gonna want manure, which we think might be over here. We're gonna have to see, but we're hoping it might. We have a swamp, which up here has a number of boons, and it seems like there might be even more valuable stuff as we extend out to the perimeter. We've got reeds, so that's going to help us make a bird cage, which will help with our farming. And other than that, we have a forest down here, which will be good for silk, we're hoping. And yeah, still plenty of area to explore. We could even extend up here, and for all we know, this may be a huge independent area. So we'll have to see about that. But yes, so I think that's going to do it for this episode. Thank you guys for watching. If you enjoyed, please feel free, but not obligated, to like and subscribe the video. And stay tuned for more Don't Starve, and hopefully a new series in the upcoming future. Thank you guys so much. Stay classy, and I'll see you next time.